Okay, and the final item of business this evening is a member's business debate on motion 11017 in the name of Jackson Carla on Calderwood Lodge Primary School 60-year celebration. The debate will be concluded without any questions being put. I'd invite members wishing to participate to press the request to speak buttons, and I call on Jackson Carlaw to open the debate around 7 minutes. Mr. Carlaw.
Thank you very much, Deputy Presiding Officer. And can I begin straight away by thanking my own colleagues through clenched teeth for keeping me up past my bedtime before we've been able to start this debate this evening. And before I do anything further, can I immediately indicate that this is very much a joint effort between myself and Paul O'Kane, who it was who came to me and said, with everything else that's happening in relation to the international situation, would it not be nice for this Parliament to be able to talk about something positive involving the Jewish community in Scotland, which rises their effort and contribution to society above all the division that there is elsewhere. And so that is the reason we're having this debate. I mused to my team today that, shooting myself rather in the foot, I said, you know, I hadn't actually realised that Calderwood Lodge was only founded in the early 60s. And they said, well, that's why you're moving a motion congratulating them on their 60th anniversary, which I suppose is a very obvious fact. But it was more because I can remember as a five-year-old having commented before in this chamber about how so many of my neighbours were Jewish, that some were going to this Calderwood Lodge. And imagine being a five-year-old and being told that. They were going to a place, I mean, this is a boy who was reading Enid Blyton at the time, and my friends were going to a place called Calderwood Lodge. It sounded very exciting. And it was in a place called New Lands. And one of my friends said they'd met a very important man who was a Teddy. And I thought, well, this is where I want to go. And this was Teddy Taylor, who had apparently visited the school. Whether people would think that was a highlight now or then or any other times, a matter of conjecture. But to me, they had a Teddy, and they were in a place called New Lands, and it was a lodge. It sounded so much more exciting than the school I was at, which was Belmont House, which was notorious, in fact, for being the childhood home of Margaret, Duchess of Argyll. For those of who know your history, will understand was slightly more racy reputation than anything else. But this school was founded in the 1960s in Newlands, in Glasgow, and was the first Jewish school. And imagine how small it must have been, because at its inception, it was one class in one year group, and it actually took a number of years as each year added to it before it had a school roll. And what was so delightful about the 60th anniversary celebration, which was much more modern, I would say, than the 50th was a black tie dinner somewhere in the constituency in the now defunct Newton Mearns Synagogue, which has since merged with the one in Giftock. This was a morning tea party with the families of those who had been at the school. And what was so nice was it wasn't just the original pupils who were present, it was their children and their grandchildren who were also going to the same school. And there were lots of activities and things to celebrate the occasion. And amongst them, there were the former headmistress, Diana Wolfson, who had been a teacher and who spoke at the event. I have to say there was still a shiver looked to me to go down the spine of some of the former pupils. I don't know how formidable an entity she must have been, but they certainly sat upright, posture straight, and listened very carefully when she was speaking. But amongst the other former pupils that were there was Gillian Friel, who is the daughter of Henry and Ingrid Wooga, and Henry Wooga will be known to many, 99 years old, heading for his centenary, the last of the kinder transport survivors we have within the community. So this is a school which has been absolutely central to so many of my constituents. It did, and Paul O'Kane will know more about this, because he was in his former guise as a councillor in East Renfrewshire Council, responsible for education, the man who actually opened the school when it moved to its new campus. I should say that the old school in Newlands is now converted into flats. There are a few remaining. maybe Patrick Harvey would want to know all this with the housing crisis. The ones that are available from £415,000 to £575,000. So I don't know if they're immediately available for access to everybody. But the school buildings there are partly demolished, but the original house live on. But the important thing is the school has now moved to this new campus. The tales of those people who were at the old school were much the same as any of us who've gone to school over the years. I mean, they had fancy dress parties. I don't know if it's true, but it was suggested that the rabbi had to come in fancy dress, and one had rather imaginatively come as a rabbi, which I thought maybe didn't fully enter into the spirit of the occasion. But they had all the same kind of colour and activity. But moreover, it wasn't just exclusive the Jewish pupils. There were other pupils there too. And particularly, they were very, very generous in the support and effort they went to with disabled pupils. At a time when other schools might not have given quite the same level of support, they went to extraordinary lengths to make disabled and severely disabled pupils in a small school have a safe and secure environment. So the 60th anniversary was celebrated. We had the chief rabbi, Ephraim Mervis, present at the occasion. And it really was, you know, a remarkable thing. The school opened in 2017 by the chief rabbi and by Bishop John Keenan from Paisley. Is this unique in the world example of two faiths working on a shared campus, shared collective resources in its centre, with other aspects round about which appeal to both the different faiths? But much more importantly still, visiting that campus, because many of the Muslim population value a faith-based education, there are lots of Muslim pupils there too. So when you visit this primary school, playing together are Jewish children, Catholic children, Muslim children. And it reminds me of lyrics I quoted in a debate maybe a decade ago on a different issue from Rodgers and Hammerstein's South Pacific, which are so opposite, I think. You've got to be taught to hate and fear. You've got to be taught from year to year. It's got to be drummed in your dear little ear. You've got to be carefully taught. You've got to be taught to be afraid of people whose eyes are oddly made and people whose skin is a different shade. You've got to be carefully taught. You've got to be taught before it's too late, before you are 6 or 7 or 8, to hate all the people your relatives hate. You've got to be carefully taught. Well, we are teaching all these young children to live together, to work together, to be educated together. And is it not through education and the example of Calderwood Lodge that Scotland's real hope for community cohesion exists? And so congratulations to Calderwood Lodge. I salute and celebrate their 60th anniversary and wish them and all who have been educated there and all who will every success in the future.
Thank you very much, Mr. Carlin, for some very useful insights into fancy dress party etiquette as well. I now call John Swinney to be followed by Paul Kane, around 4 minutes. Mr. Swinney.
Presiding Officer, it's an enormous pleasure to follow Jackson Carlo and to express my congratulations to Mr. Carlo on securing this debate and on placing the motion. And while I'm on my feet at this moment in such difficult and challenging times in relation to the international conflict, it gives me the opportunity to commend Jackson Carlo on the speech that he delivered to Parliament yesterday, which, although I didn't agree with all of it, was a thoughtful, reflective and gracious speech, typical of Mr. Carlo, frankly, which I think enhanced our debate yesterday. So I'm grateful to have the opportunity to put that on the record of Parliament today. I also have great pleasure in adding my congratulations to Calderwood Lodge Primary School on its 60th anniversary, the 60th anniversary of it being the only Jewish school in Scotland. And when I listen to Mr. Carlo talking about the roots of the school, it is essentially a product of innovation in education, of recognising that there is space in our education system for there to be creative approaches taken by a community 60 years ago to make sure this educational tradition could be established. And now look at what has been created as a consequence as we look at the new build, Calderwood Lodge Primary School, and the joint campus that is, of which it is now a part. In my 5 years as Education Secretary, and I know Members of Parliament might be a bit sceptical when I say they were very happy years. They were challenging years, but there was a lot of joy in my years as Education Secretary. And part of the joy I could see, I can see reflected in some of what Calderwood Lodge is trying to achieve. The school's vision is to empower, and I quote, empower our hearts and minds to develop the knowledge and skills, attitudes and values to be the best we can for our future, our community and our global environment. And at the heart of the school's aims, to develop our school's Jewish identity and ethos while promoting respect for all global cultures and religions. What on earth could be finer motivations and foundations for the educational attainment of children in our society today in Scotland? The fact that Calderwood Lodge School has developed as a joint campus with the leadership of East Renfrewshire Council, of which Paul O'Kane was a distinguished former education convener, with the joint campus along with St Clair's Roman Catholic Primary School, in a sense lives out that aim I've just talked about promoting respect for all global cultures and religions. And what better way to do it than in a joint campus with a Roman Catholic Primary School? As the father of a son who was educated in his primary education in the Roman Catholic school within a joint campus, I think joint campus developments have been an absolutely fabulous innovation in Scottish education, where tradition has been protected and nurtured, but where common cause and common space has been created. And again, what more could we hope for the educational environment in which our children are living? And something very special about all of that would be marked by the opening of the school jointly by the Chief Rabbi Ephraim Mirvis and Bishop John Keenan of Paisley, which I think symbolises all of that coming together. One other element of it, of that coming together, is what was contributed to the joint campus by the Scottish Government, where a very modest amount of money, £300,000, was contributed from the Scottish Government for the creation of an interactive hub, a shared faith space at the heart of the campus. And I cannot think in a joint campus which is trying to provide the opportunities for communities of distinctiveness to come together, I cannot think of a finer way to do that by investing in a faith space where we can all bring our traditions together. We can respect our traditions, we can celebrate each other's traditions, and we can cherish our traditions. And that surely is the foundation of the common humanity that all of us want to see and which so many of us are distressed about in the current environment in which we are living. So this is a lovely moment to celebrate the 60th anniversary of the foundation of Calderwood Lodge, to pay tribute to those who had the imagination and the creativity to make this happen, and to subsequent generations who've been prepared to invest and to make the choices which Councillor O'Kane, Paul O'Kane and his former guise as a councillor, was able to do to ensure that we've got fantastic educational facilities for young people. And I commend the motion and all that it aims to achieve for the children and young people of Calderwood Lodge Primary School.
Thank you, Mr Swinney. I now call Paul Keane to be followed by Sandy Scolhaney, around 4 minutes.
Thank you very much, Deputy Presiding Officer, and I'll start by declaring an interest as the former Education Convener in East Renfrewshire, as we've heard. I'm very pleased to be participating in this debate this evening, and I thank Jackson Carlaw for his kind words and for the way in which we've been able to work together to bring this motion to the Chamber this evening, and indeed I think for Jackson Carlaw's long support of the Jewish community in East Renfrewshire. We both have a strong relationship with that community over many years, and I think there is a real cross-party consensus in East Renfrewshire where we work to support all of our diverse communities indeed. As we've heard already, these are undoubtedly dark times for Jewish people around the world. And many of the conversations I have had with the Jewish community in East Renfrewshire recently have been in grief, in prayer for those murdered in Israel, and often of fear. Fear for their own safety and security as anti-Semitism rises. And I think what we heard yesterday in the debate in this place and across much of the commentary, we must all stand together against that anti-Semitism and that rising tide of anti-Semitism we are seeing all too often in our world. But I'm very clear that that is not how Jewish people want to be defined or how they want to be seen. And indeed, I heard, I think, most clearly when, along with Jackson Carlow, I joined the community in celebrating 60 years of Scotland's only Jewish school, Calderwood Lodge. I heard a variety of voices speaking in joyful celebration and in hope for what has been achieved over 60 years in that community, and indeed what they will go on to achieve in the future here in Scotland. And I think it was exemplified, that hope and that joy, in the smiling faces and the angelic voices of the children of the school who shared traditional Hebrew songs with us as we tucked into a great brunch that morning in Calderwood Lodge. The community is rightly proud, Deputy Presiding Officer, of what many describe as the jewel in the crown of the Jewish story here in Scotland. And that story is long and varied, just as the school story is long and varied. And indeed, we've heard much of that articulated by Jackson Carlow this evening. It was my honour to serve on East Renfrewshire Council for 10 years, 5 years as Vice Convener of Education and 4 as Convener. And I'm very grateful to John Swinney for his comments in that regard. And whilst John Swinney and I often disagreed on elements of policy when I was Convener, there was a real sense that on issues like this, on issues about improving school facilities, about making sure that we pushed forward in terms of bringing communities together, we were very much working with one purpose. And I know that over his time as Cabinet Secretary, many of the schools in East Renfrewshire greatly valued the time that he gave to visit schools and speak with staff, pupils and parents. And I know that his visits were always well regarded. So I'm grateful to him for that. Indeed, I think I will focus my remaining time on my time and my involvement in the rebuilding of the school to its current site in Newton Mearns. It had been long the ambition of the council to relocate the school and provide new and modern facilities. And I'm proud that we chose to do this by investing £17 million in what we believe to be the world's first joint Jewish Roman Catholic shared campus. It was a courageous and bold plan in many ways, but it did enjoy the support of parents for both faith communities, the leaders of those faith communities, staff, and indeed the wider community in East Renfrewshire. It wasn't always plain sailing. Trust had to be built, and I do recall many late meetings of parent councils and community groups just ironing out some of those issues and concerns and finding common ground. And common ground was the key, respecting one another's faith and traditions and deciding to share where we could on encounter, experience and humanity. And I remember when the architects presented the plans for the building, they spoke about there being a central heart, and it's the facility that John Swinney referred to. It would be a place where children could come together, that the busyness of school life would pause for a while, and there would be a time together to share meals, dance, drama, social occasions, faith experiences. And to both schools, when we talked about that heart, there was a real sense that that was nothing new, having a heart in the school. Because for them, it wasn't just about the heart and the centre of the building. It was actually about so much more. For 60 years, Calderwood Lodge has been a beating heart, a place of learning and love, where Jewish children have learned alongside Muslim children and children of other faiths and no faiths, where lives have been shaped, minds have been inspired. It stands as a beacon of hope, of perseverance, of tolerance and respect. As the motion rightly states, it is an asset to East Renfrewshire and to Scotland. It rightly commands the pride of the Jewish community and the local authority. And tonight, in concluding, may I suggest that it commands this Parliament's pride and respect also. So let us, with one voice, say to the community of Calderwood Lodge, Mazel Tov, to all pupils, teachers and the community, past and present, Chazach ve'amaz. Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Mr. O'Kane. I now call Sandish Gulhani, around 4 minutes, please, Dr. Gulhani.
Thank you. I'm delighted to speak in the Chamber to honour Calderwood Lodge Primary School, which is now in its 60th year of providing Jewish faith-based education. For me, growing up in Golders Green, Jewish schools were the norm, though I went to the state garden suburb myself. My colleague Jackson Carlaw and others have spoken eloquently about the school's history, from its early days in Glasgow Newlands to the more recent move to Newton Mearns, where it shares a joint campus with St Clair's Primary School. This is the first Jewish Catholic joint campus in the world, and having kids of Jewish, Catholic and Muslim faiths playing together, learning together, is wonderful and growing multiculturalism. While the school's direct impact extends primarily to the Jewish community, Calderwood Lodge Primary School contributes to the broader educational cultural landscape in East Renfrewshire, showcasing the importance of diversity in the region. The school fosters a sense of pride and identity in the pupils' heritage within a strong Jewish ethos, while also promoting respect for all global cultures and religions. By existing alongside other schools, Calderwood Lodge contributes to interfaith understanding and collaboration, promoting a diverse and inclusive environment. And it's no surprise that this is important to the ethos of Calderwood Lodge Primary School. We only need to look at the contribution of Scotland's Jewish community as a whole to the cultural, social and economic fabric of our country, particularly in Glasgow and East Renfrewshire. Scotland's Jewish community is heavily engaged in philanthropic, education and community initiatives, fostering diversity, understanding and appreciation among different communities, promoting tolerance, enriching Scotland's social tapestry. Jewish entrepreneurs and professionals contribute to the economic landscape, creating business, generating employment and participating in academia, innovation and development. Our Jewish friends are at the forefront of promoting interfaith dialogue, helping to build bridges between different religions and cultural groups, actively encouraging mutual respect and understanding. The history of the Jewish community in Scotland is indeed rich and varied and dates back to the late medieval period. But don't worry, I won't go all the way back there. We'll fast forward to the early 20th century, where there is a well-established Jewish community in Glasgow. Then, during World War II, Scotland provided a safe haven to Jewish refugees escaping Nazi persecution. And many Jewish refugees integrated into Scottish society, contributing to various fields. In the post-war period, our Jewish community continued to grow, and synagogues, schools and community organisations were established, with notable contributions made in business, science and the arts. Today, the Jewish community in Scotland is diverse, with members contributing across various aspects of Scottish life. And our synagogues, community centres and educational institutions play crucial roles in preserving Jewish identity and fostering connections with broader community. Calderwood Lodge Primary School continues this much-valued tradition. Family and community are at the core of the school experience, underpinned by the study of Hebrew and Jewish values. Children are guided to develop the necessary skills to make positive contributions to Scotland and the world at large, now and in the future. So, congratulations to Calderwood Lodge on its 60th anniversary.
Thank you very much, Dr. Gohani. I now invite Graham Day to respond to the debate. Minister, around 7 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Presiding Officer, the challenge in responding on behalf of the government to debates like these is that everyone who's gone before you, not least of all the person whose member's business it is, has covered pretty much everything. So if the next few minutes offer little fresh insight, please accept my apologies. And of course, seeking to match the eloquence and the humour of the delivery of Jackson Carlaw on most topics is similarly a task beyond most of us, certainly me, and certainly tonight. But can I say how much I enjoyed Jackson Carlaw's contribution? I want to thank him for bringing forward this debate. I want to thank also the other contributors, particularly Paul O'Kane, because collectively I think they've shone a light on the history and the achievements of Calderwood School, and in so doing, reminded all of us in passing about what members' business was designed to be about, parking the politics and, as MSPs, marking significant landmarks for organisations within our constituency and beyond, and highlighting the good about our communities, the communities we are privileged to represent. And we've had some lovely, thought-provoking points made, highlighting the special nature of Calderwood Lodge. And as others have done, I absolutely congratulate them on the achievement of reaching their 60th anniversary. To pick up on some of the points that were made, I thought Jackson Carlow noting the particular nature of the school, where generations of the same household have gone there. I think that's quite unique in education these days, with the movement of families around the country. John Swinney highlighted the aims and the vision of the school, and he was right in noting the worthiness of these. And Paul O'Kane took us back to the establishment 6 years ago of the current facility and talked about the trust-building exercise that had to be embarked upon. I don't doubt how challenging that must have been at the time, but I'm sure he sits there tonight and thinks how worthwhile it was to take on that challenge. Presiding officer, denominational schools have played a key role in the Scottish education system for over 100 years and provide our faith communities with an opportunity to bear witness to that faith through the education of their children. Many other denominational schools have a diverse intake, reflecting the range of faiths within the communities. Parents of other faiths and no faith often choose a denominational school for their children's education. But Calderwood Lodge, as we've heard from Jackson Carlow, with that Muslim cohort also at the school, is quite unique here, I suspect. And it demonstrates that community cohesion indeed. Members have mentioned the joint campus, which brought together Calderwood Lodge and St Clair's Primary Schools in the same site, and that it was the first of its kind in Scotland. As John Swinney reminded us in 2017, the Scottish Government was pleased to provide a modest sum, as he said, of £300,000 towards the project to create that shared faith space at the heart of the campus to encourage new ways of learning, teaching and socialising, as well as encouraging interfaith interaction whilst fostering respect, collaboration and understanding. Presiding officer, diversity and equality are at the heart of the policies that underpin education in Scotland, and we need to be vigilant in challenging any discriminatory and abusive behaviours in our schools in any form. Where it occurs, it must be challenged to educate our children about all faiths and belief systems and none, and ensuring they learn tolerance, respect, equality and good citizenship, as well as healthy relationships. And I think Calderwood Lodge, from what we've heard tonight, lights the way for us in that regard. The Government's Anti-Racism in Education programme provides oversight to a number of areas of work which are embedding anti-racism in education, including education leadership, professional learning, increasing diversity in the teaching profession, decolonising the curriculum and tackling racist incidents in school. The Scottish Government absolutely values and appreciates our relationship with Scotland's Jewish communities and welcomes their contribution and input to our nation's civic life. We acknowledge the cultural and religious identity of these communities, and we will continue to work together to tackle prejudice and support each other in building society we want to be, a safer, stronger and fairer Scotland. Events in Israel and Palestine, as awful as they are, do not justify expressions of racial or religious hatred of any kind. And although we're not seeing the same rise in reported hate crime as has been seen elsewhere on these islands, we should not be complacent in this regard. Now, the government quite recently set out, and just this week, in fact, the Minister for Victims and Community Safety launched the Hate Crime Strategy Delivery Plan at the Tackle on Hate Crime and Building Cohesive Communities conference. But to be honest, Presiding Officer, we should not need strategies or delivery plans here, because this is about tolerance, respect and decency, the hallmarks which should underpin any society, particularly our society. To conclude, Presiding Officer, we greatly value Calderwood Lodge's primary's contribution to the Jewish community in East Renfrewshire. The school is rightly a source of pride, not only to that community, but others and the wider community in that locality. Can I conclude by once again congratulating Calderwood Lodge on reaching this milestone, but also again congratulate Jackson Carlow for securing this platform to highlight that and for an excellent speech. Presiding Officer.
Thank you very much, Minister. That concludes the debate, and I close this meeting of Parliament.